Find the degree of the Taylor polynomial n necessary such that the error between f of x and the nth degree Taylor polynomial at a given x value will be less than a given error value. So here's our example. We want to find something about f of x equals cosine of x, and let the p sub n be the nth degree Taylor polynomial at x equals pi. So find n so that the error will be less than 0.01 at x equals 5. The Taylor polynomial is centered at x equals pi, and 5 is not too far away, so we might be able to make it the error less than 0.01 with a decent amount of terms. So let's find them. We know that the error term, or the error, is less than this. And we know that the n plus 1 derivative of f everywhere for this function is less than or equal to 1, because all these derivatives are only going to be plus or minus sine, or they're going to be plus or minus cosine. So all their values, no matter what x is, travel between negative 1 and 1. Negative 1 and 1. So the maximum value on any interval, and specifically at x equals 5, is going to be m equals 1. That's the maximum value that it can be. So that's the m bound. And that goes up here in the formula. You see, here's your m, and there's your m right there, 1. It's not always 1, but it is for this function. And then your x that you're concerned with is 5, so it's 5 minus pi to the n plus 1. And we want that to be less than or equal to 0.01. So that's going to be kind of hard to solve for it. So what you do is you put in y1 in your calculator. You put in that term there. And you get the factorial sign from math and the probability. And that's where it is. Math, probability. So then you set your table to start at 1, delta table 1, and to ask. And you just put in n values until you reach a number which comes out, the value of this is less than or equal to 0.01, which is this one. So n equals 7. Hence we need P7, the seventh degree Taylor polynomial, to make the error at 5 be less than 0.01. But the Taylor polynomial comes out like this. It skips power terms, and we've seen that before. It's a second power, it's a fourth, it's a sixth. There is no seventh. So P7 has a zero coefficient, so we might as well just use the sixth degree. So Taylor polynomial of the sixth degree will do in this case. That's just because for the cosine at pi, the powers are skipping the odd ones. Okay, and then you evaluate. Here's P6, and I got that out of Wolfram Alpha. Or you could calculate it, of course. P6 at 5, just plug in 5 here, here, and there. Gives you this number here. And the cosine of 5 gives you this number. So the error between them is going to be the subtraction. And that comes out negative 0.0034. And that absolute value is definitely less than or equal to 0.01. So it verifies out. We determined that we needed a P6 Taylor polynomial to do the trick at x equals 5. So the arrow would be under 0.01. And it was indeed under 0.01. One last thing. So now you know what the O x minus pi to the seventh terminology is on Wolfram Alpha. Because they usually write it like this. They give you some terms, and then they write O. That means order of. It's the error term of order n plus 1 to the 7th degree. So what they're talking about is this error term that we've been doing. That's all that means. And what order is that error term? That's this right here, you see? It's the n plus 1 power. So that's all that big O stuff means.